We are learning new details tonight surrounding the murder of a woman in Waikiki last spring. The boyfriend of Ivy Harris, who authorities now say was her pimp, is accused of bringing her to Oahu to work, a trip that resulted in her death. Breanne Randall joins us with more on our top story. Breanne?
Joe, young women coming here for prostitution is a huge problem in Hawaii, but often goes undetected. It's a crime trend that Ivy's case has brought front and center.
Last year, Mark Miles spoke with KHON2 during a vigil for Ivy Harris, a Portland, Oregon woman who was found murdered near Yokohama Bay. Today, he was in federal custody, charged in connection with transporting Ivy to Hawaii to work as a prostitute. A Marine Master Sergeant is accused of killing her in his hotel room.
Unfortunately, when we got to Ivy's case, it was too late. She had already been murdered by one of her Johns. But we knew the entire time that she was a victim of trafficking as well. These victims are always misidentified, that their pimps are referred to as their boyfriends, and nobody really investigates further.
This time, the FBI did, as part of Operation Traffic Stop. When Ivy disappeared last May, her friends and family said Miles was her boyfriend. A federal indictment unsealed today says he was her pimp, taking her to Hawaii several times to make money off of her. The acting special agent in charge of the FBI in Oregon said, quote, "Until now, successful pimps reaped all the rewards with none of the risk, while the girls and young women they manipulated faced a life of violence and abuse."
Hawaii sees hundreds of women and girls come through its state line, also the ones that are trafficked here locally.
But Miles was not acting alone. Seven other Portland area pimps, including Stephen Huffman and Michael Willis Jr., were also charged with transporting young women for prostitution. They sent women all over the country to have sex with strangers for money, including Alaska, Nevada, Idaho, and Minnesota.
Most often these traffickers work as a crew, as a group. It becomes organized crime at that point, but they work together in a network to facilitate their trafficking endeavors.
Two more suspects are also charged with sex trafficking of a minor, but have not yet been arrested, and those indictments remain sealed.
Now, Miles faces multiple crimes that combined carry a sentence of 15 years in prison. A judge will decide tomorrow whether he will be released before a trial in April. Breanne Randall, KHON 2 News.